Urban services and infrastructures can be considered the conjunction of intestines and essential organs of a city. One of the main challenges of today is to change the existing systems, infrastructures and services from a sustainable perspective, both as a remedial device for the contemporary city and an organizing principle for new cities. A change towards circular systems which aim to minimize new inputs and maximize recycling, and thus to reduce pollution and wastes. To achieve a shift towards a more sustainable systems, urban professionals, designers and decision makers often aim immediately to implement new systems based on renewables, like for instance the introduction of new technologies or the placing of photovoltaic panels on top of the roofs of buildings. For instance, here projected on a typical part of Amsterdam kennel houses and urban blocks. Besides of the negative aspects of a too much techno-fix way of approach with all kinds of drawbacks, starting with new technologies overlooks essential primary steps to take before that, to achieve sustainable development of essential streams and related infrastructures. As there is a preferred order in approach, the right order, known as the trias ecologica or trias energetica, is to first of all start with the reduction of demand. For instance, the demand for mobility, energy or water. In case of energy, for instance, reductions from 30 up to 50% of the amount originally used can be achieved already. But also in case of mobility, significant reduction of demand and thus reduction of necessary investments in new capacity or systems can be achieved. The second step is to try to recycle available surplus. This can be, for instance, the availability of waste heat in an area by matching cooling demand of a supermarket with reusing the produced heat in that supermarket for the heating demand of apartments built on top of it. But it can also be related to the reuse of nutrients in wastewater or of clean water for agriculture. Next, the third step in the trias ecologica concerns the introduction of generation of the essentials based on renewables. For instance, in case of energy, the use of solar panels, heat pumps or windmills. However, in our existing organization of cities, still a fourth final step needs to be taken, which is the use of existing resources. If this is the case, aim should be to use these resources as efficient as possible, here shown as the fourth step. Of course, the approach is called trias energetica or trias ecologica, as the aim should be to avoid such a fourth step at all. This three or four step approach also needs to be seen in relation to scale. As reduction of demand, the first step always considers the lowest scale of implementation, the user or the individual building. The second step in this approach, the reuse of existing surplus or so-called residual effluents, should be started at this lowest scale level too. But after that, this should be considered for the subsequent larger scales. Like for instance that of the neighborhood, the city district and the city region or metropolitan area. The third step, renewable generation, then can be considered at either of the scales where spatial, technical, social and economical aspects will define the optimal scale of implementation. Again, like stated before, realizing more efficient use of the existing, be it either on a centralized scale level, at a metropolitan scale, or at the scale of the individual buildings, such a fourth step should preferably be avoided. With respect to the implementation and the architectural or urban integration of the different systems, it is important to be aware that nowadays, almost at all scale levels, we can find feasible solutions. For instance, on an individual scale level, or that of a household, we can purify wastewater to clean water based on natural systems, like shown here to the left in a so-called living machine. This living machine is placed in a conservatory. But we can also generate energy via an individual pole with integrated solar panels or a decentralized vertical axis windmill, like shown here second and third from the left. But also more compact autonomous systems, either natural or entirely technical systems, to compost excreta, purify grey wastewater or rainwater into secondary use water or even into drinking water can be achieved. Important to notice here, however, is that to achieve certain optimization in efficiencies related to the environmental or technical processes, and thus also regarding costs and maintenance and implementation and space use, the individual scale level in general is not considered to be the optimal scale level. In particular, not in case of urban environments and higher densities, or in case of clear urban living. In particular, social aspects will support real, sustainable, or durable functioning of such systems. Therefore, a community-based, clustered, or so-called decentralized scale of implementation is lately more often considered. Shown here is again the concept of a living machine, but in this case at the scale of a community in Findhorn, Scotland. Also, the Danish village of Marstal, where over 70% of its heat demand for the entire village is covered with solar energy generated with the solar collector plant shown here at the bottom of the image. And to the right, a biogas plant in Latvia, which produces energy, clean water and soil out of wastewater. The existing so-called paradigm or ruling way of doing in general, however, still concerns a centralized organization. Although this is from a sustainability perspective more and more frequently questioned as optimum. But from a security, management and related cost perspective, this still is considered as one of the best scale levels of implementation. From a social perspective, however, this is not necessarily the case, as the distance between user and solution is large, and thus it anonymizes use, and therefore also doesn't avoid wrong use or any learning regarding. Therefore, as stated, today's search for alternatives more frequently tries to find solutions at the previously shown intermediate scale level of a neighborhood or a city district. To be able to include the positive aspects from technical and cost perspective related to the scale economy and so-called heteronomy or interconnection at larger scales, but also to the social aspects which request finding community-based solutions, either autonomous, clustered, or within a decentralized system consisting of several smaller systems, as shown to the right. In the end, the optimal organization of infrastructures and services always will be place-specific. Nevertheless, lately a shift towards hybrid solutions and solutions at smaller scale levels can be noticed. This is also the result of new ICT systems, which make it easier to respond real-time to variations in demand and supply, and to provide feedback loops. The optimal scale for such an organization looks like the one shown here, in which an intermediate scale is introduced between that of the individual buildings and centralized systems. In this intermediate decentralized hub, supply and demand of the different essential streams and related infrastructures can be matched, while it is also including storage to overcome misfits between peaks in demand and supply.